real, relevant, and rollicking. That's our spirit. Women in leadership, they've all come together and learned from one another to know each other, and there's a sense of bonding.
It's phenomenal to have this many women coming to share their passion and continue to walk in the footsteps of Catherine McAuley. And as we continue to respond to the calling to serve in mercy.
Greetings from the famous red doors here in Bagot Street.
You know, Catherine never said, this is my ministry or this is what I did and so forth. You know, that pronoun of we. We do this together.
If we're really friends, we got to be honest. And if we're really sisters, we're required to be honest.
Being you and being authentic, I think that's what leadership is. If you don't give voice to the truth that is moving inside you, we are all denied the fullness of God's Spirit.
The greatest gift that we can give to one another is presence.
So it takes a spaciousness of heart, I think, to respond to the sufferings around us. And we need the support of each other to do that.
We exist to serve those who are poor, in need of health education, and also those wounded by contemporary society. So in no way do we have a say, no, we don't do that. We have a nose for need. And all the funds from this will be going to our ministry in Laredo, Texas.
In 21 years, we have never turned anyone away.
Predominantly to help the women, refugees, and others.
There's a lot of women that are in violent relationships down there, and they take those women in, and a lot of times they don't have anything.
Charity without justice is nothing. It's still not the same.
So never, never underestimate the power of community. We're paving the way for that next generation. And to do that around the time that Catherine McAuley opened the doors in 1827. It's phenomenal.
As a new leader myself, it fills my cup. It grows me positively and energizes me to go back to bring this to my team.
And let those gifts and talents serve many more people. Hurrah for mercy.